So in this episode I want to show you the basics of using rulers in Pages, and in the next episode I want to show you some advanced features. So rulers can be turned on by going to View, Show Ruler. And what you get at the top there is a ruler that shows you, usually in inches but you can change that, the horizontal layout of your document. So it starts at 0 and goes to 8.5. In this case, 8.5 inches for standard paper in the United States. You've got some little triangles here that you can drag around. And they will change things in the document, but only for what you've selected. So let's select everything in the document. Or better yet, let's select only the first two paragraphs so you can see. If I drag the little triangle on the right around, it's going to change the right margin, but only for what's selected. If I drag on the left margin. But notice that the triangle on the left is actually a little bit bigger than the one on the right. It's because it's actually two parts. It's the triangle and then there's this top part here which is actually the indentation. So I can indent each paragraph a little bit and I can drag the whole margin and they both go together. You can actually control these without using the ruler at all by on the right going to Format and then Layout. And you can see here the indent on the left and the right. So as I move these around you can see those numbers change. There. So you have the ability to do it without the ruler. Now in addition you can also add tab stops, which are where the text starts when you're using the tab key on your keyboard. So I'm going to click in a blank area here and I'm going to create this little sideways triangle here and that's a tab. So when I go and put the cursor there and hit tab it jumps to this spot here. And you can actually double click on the tab and it will change to one of various different things. And you can see it all shown here in the layout. So I've got a left tab, I've got a center tab, a right tab, and a decimal tab, which is for making lists with numbers and there's like a decimal point to it. So most of the time you're just going to use the left tab for most purposes. But let's create another tab stop here. You can put something there. So I've got three tab stops and I'm going to, there we go, three tab stops and I've got three tab characters. If I go and show invisibles you can see the tabs right there. So I got this first tab and then it lines up with that. The next tab lines up with this and the next one lines up with that. If I change this, double click on it and change it to a center, you can see that this word here for this tab is now centered underneath that. If I do it to the right, you can see the right side is aligned with it. The tricky part of using rulers and tabs is to remember it only affects what you've selected. So I select this line, you can see all that tab work I did here. But if I select, say, this paragraph down here, you can see the indentations and there's no tabs there at the top because it's on a paragraph for paragraph basis. So in the next video I'm going to show you all sorts of cool ways that you can use rulers that are beyond this standard word processing stuff.